If this threat is carried out and the bulldozers arrive, then we shall fight. We shall fight on the doorsteps of our homes. We shall fight at the gates of churchyards. We shall fight in the farm fields, and we shall fight at the church doors.
The Churchillian battle cry uttered by the Vicar of Dunton. And a few miles away, the ancient signals of distress are set ablaze on the hills surrounding the village of Coblington. The people have just learned that their hamlets and farms, their homes and their churches, may soon be leveled to make way for London's third airport. 2 years ago, the British government appointed a commission to recommend a site for a new airport. Headed by a High Court judge, it considered four possibilities, and just weeks ago came out in favor of Coblington, 45 miles northwest of London. One of the last stretches of open country between London and Birmingham. There's hardly any industry here. It's a land of gentlemen farmers and retired colonels, where people send their sons to private schools and go fox hunting on Sundays. It's a place where traditional English country life is still very real, where the landed gentry cling to their ways with a feudal passion. Bill Manning, 63 years old, was born on this farm, as were his father, grandfather.
Is there any particular spot that you'd miss the most?
Well, two things I would miss the most is Wing Church, which you can see across there, which commands a view of the whole of my land. And I wake up in the morning, pull the blinds, and there the old church is. And that would be, well, it would be a tragedy, really, to not to have it with us.
And what's the other thing?
And I think the other thing I would miss, as much as anything, is the one or two rather old pubs. Local life centres around the pubs a bit, and to go in there in the evenings and the old places is something, you know, we can never get again.
Building the airport here would involve destroying three villages and displacing 1,000 families. 30,000 other homes would be affected by noise. It would also obliterate some of the loveliest countryside in England. Many thought the commission would opt for Foul Ness, a marshland by the Thames estuary, where an airport could be built by reclaiming land from the seas. With the aid of a cost-benefit analysis, the commission reluctantly concluded that Coblington is the right answer. And it couldn't have picked an area with more influential people, more determined to drum up vast resources to fight for their land. Some workers and farmhands here think an airport would bring new and better jobs to the district, but their numbers are few, and their voices are drowned in a wave of protest which is only beginning to be felt.
Are you a farmer,
sir? I am a farmer at Stewkley, yes.
How would it affect you if the airport is
built? Well, my old future, as far as I can see, is absolutely finished. I just don't know what to do. I've no training for any other job. And also, I think my father and mother in the village, born and bred, that old 75 odd. They're going to be destroyed. You might as well put them against a wall and shoot them as move them.
This meeting reaffirms its implacable opposition to the siting of the Third London Airport at Coblington, which would destroy, for a doubtful short-term advantage, the lives and homes of thousands of people, together with a priceless piece of English countryside.
Let us take encouragement from the enormous amount of support throughout the country and at Westminster, which has already made itself known. And let no one doubt both our capacity and our determination to succeed.
A
Of course, the whole problem is created by the ever-increasing number of people, particularly tourists, who fly into London every year. But if places like Cublington continue to disappear under concrete, there may soon be fewer people who'll see any reason to visit England. Bob Simon, CBS News, Buckinghamshire.